Hey guys, it's Morgan with Raising the Bar Performance, and today we're focusing on hip mobility and activating the glutes for your squats and your deadlift. Right now, you can see here I'm using a foam roller. What the foam roller does is it helps to break up the fascia that gets built up over time as you are lifting and working those muscles. It also does is allows for better blood flow through those muscles and joints for movement purposes. Here I am rolling out my hip up and my glute. So you can see the foam roller starts at the top of the hip and I can roll all the way down the leg. I can choose to go all the way down to the knee. What I am doing here is kind of rotating back and forth to hit different spots. Some spots are tighter than others, so you want to make sure you get a full release in there. To advance the movement or add more pressure, you can cross the heel of the glute that you're rolling out across the knee and put more pressure into the foam roller. Next up, I'm going to go ahead and roll out my back. Your back plays a huge role in your overall movement for the squat. So you want to make sure those muscles are nice and loose and broken up so that they don't restrict any movement going in. Next up, I'm going to do the front. So still in the hip, right at the top of the hip, you can really dig in to release any build up there. And again, you can rotate back and forth. You don't have to stay in one straight line. Really dig in and find those spots for yourself. Everybody's going to be a little bit different in that sense. Not the same spots are going to be tight. And if you don't feel that they're tight, then you may not need to be rolling out that area. But really work from the top of the hip all the way down to the knee for the quads. You can rotate to the side and get the IT bands. Just honestly, wherever you feel is tight, you want to work out so that it doesn't affect your squat later. Once we finish up here, I'm going to go ahead and use a resistance band and go into a kneeling hip thruster. So what this band is going to do, it's going to pull my hips back and help them release, as well as my quads, and then I'm going to be able to fire my glutes better throughout the movement. If you're someone like me who's very quad dominant, this is really important. You don't want your quads to take over during your squat. You want to make sure that your glutes are able to fire as well. Here I'm pushing into a lunge and driving through that hip, so I'm going to release that hip and activate the glute at the same time. Make sure you do both sides when you're doing movements like this. You want to make sure your body's working on both sides and firing properly on both sides as well. Next, we're going to move into a lateral lunge. So again, opening up that hip even more, pressing it out to the side and firing the glute as we come up from that lunge. And then you can also work into a reverse lunge, pushing the hips forward and stepping back. Once we're finished up with the lunges, we're going to move into a variety of movements that really dial in on the hips and make sure that they're firing properly. Your first one is a Superman. By doing the Superman, you want to make sure you're squeezing the shoulder blades together and then recruiting your glutes, back, and hamstrings to pull up on that movement. Here you have a prone step out. That prone step out being while you're laying down, you can isolate the glutes a little bit more and get them activating as you pull out to the side. And you have your fire hydrants. Feel free to do these with or without a band. Probably start without a band first and get that knee up so that it's parallel with the ceiling. And finally, you have hip thrusters. So again, squeezing through the core and the glutes, shifting the weight to the shoulders. You're going to feel this in your hamstring and glutes as well.